Hello my friends, today we're gonna create a beamer from an old box and a magnifying glass. I can see red, I can see all the colors.
I'm trying to get closer. You can see my red shirt? This is what I see on the ceiling now. It works, man. This is beamer for poor people, you know, poor people beamer. Wow, I love it, man.
Kinda amazing, eh? It works. But hey, that was the prototype what you just saw. So let's now go ahead and create, you know, a better model that will give us better results.
Project Beamer. Project Beamer. From the old box. And of course, a magnifying glass. So how to make a thing like that? Well, I already made one and you could see the results. This is my first one. I'm kind of happy about it, but in fact, I have a bigger magnifying glass here. So I have a box here and I know that the distance perfect.
Well, perfect? No, not exactly, Puck. You're gonna use a different magnifying glass now, so you don't know nothing about that distance yet. We will have to see what that distance is. Now check this, you can make this from any box. You could even, you know, build some wooden box to do this if you know the right measurements. And in fact, I have an idea to create an even better model than this, but a shoebox will do just fine. Also make sure that you kind of make the shoebox black from the inside. So in fact, it's all about putting the magnifying glass at the front and then closing up the box and find a way to put the phone in.
So how's the best way to put it? The best way to put it is to make a way for it to go in here in the box.
In my case, it was kind of better to make a kind of cut into the front of the flat part that in fact we cut off from the front, and then just simply slide the holder of the magnifying glass of this model, simply just slide it into that to that cut, so we have a kind of good mounting of the of this magnifying glass. But if you had a round magnifying glass, of course you would then cut a round hole in the front of the box of the shoebox, and then you wouldn't have to go through all this hassle. But I'm using this special magnifying glass, and I found out that I have better results with this bigger glass. It gives more light, and I have one more of these glasses, so maybe in my updated project I'm gonna do something crazy.
So it kind of closes a little bit from the front, you see that? And we do the same with here, okay? One more cut here. Okay. Are we happy about that?
Now it's time to fit the magnifying glass into the box. Of course, we can do that with some tape. And I have some good tape here, so let's go ahead and tape it so it looks kind of good and that it's kind of sitting stable. And I don't have so much tape, so I must be very careful not to spill it. As you can see, the inside of my box is still white, and we will get better results if we kind of make it black from the inside, because the white is also giving it's not good for the for the reflection of the light. It must be completely black, and if you kind of make it black, you will have better results.
This is also not a perfect way to fold. Never come straight. But again, the shape of this thing can be anything. This one will go like that. And then here we must make the cut a little bit lower.
Okay, now it's time to put some duct tape on the front of the box together with the magnifying glass. We're gonna go just a little bit over the edge of the magnifying glass, so the magnifying glass also is held by the tape. So it's kind of challenging, because in fact I needed two more hands to do this, but this is just my prototype number two. It's not the official. It will never become official, I think. Maybe I will make some model of some a better model, something that is easier to create and to make. So I will work on that in my next project, and with maybe even better results. As I said, I have another one of these magnifying glasses, and I want to see if I can do something even more crazy with the two of them, if I will get kind of better results. Also, I want to test in my next build if maybe aluminium foil instead of black on the inside will give a better result. So all these things I must test. I'm not sure about it yet. So this video will get some tail. Het krijgt nog een staartje, om het zo te zeggen, to see really what we can get out of this and how we can make it the very best. Okay, I think we must do some other things. That's right, because in fact I found out that the space from the magnifying glass to the phone is a little bit too big. All magnifying glasses have, of course, different specs, and the round one have other specs than this square one. So I will have to make the box a little bit smaller. But first, we're gonna find the right size for the box. So we're gonna do a test first. I'm gonna put in the phone in some way. We're gonna go to the dark room and do a test and find the right measurements.
Okay, we have something on the wall there. I'm gonna go a little bit further, see what's gonna happen. Okay, so what I find out here is that with this magnifying glass I should go even closer. Oh, look at that! Look at that! This is bloody sharp. Look at that. Can you see it? This is sharp, so let me see how far I should go. I should be here. 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 Okay. Let me make a sketch there. Here. I learned something from my system. For this glass, I need a smaller box, but it's not a problem. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut this here and round it. Okay, so in fact, we need to go up to here. Wow, it's 6 o'clock in the morning. Oh my gosh, I stood up so early this morning. No, but I never went to bed yet. Which one is it? Put this one inside. It's a little bit challenging to put it inside, okay? You must get used to that. And also pressing the full screen is kind of challenging. This one is not really. You should go a little bit more to the back. Stand like this. Very nice. Very, very nice. Okay, this is pretty good. But the height is important. Again, full screen. This is it. Look at that. Well, peeps, this is it. Look at that. And you can make it kind of big, but then it gets kind of blurred. See, I think this is kind of about it. Okay. It's working. I I think it's even better than the other one that I had. Just fit it to the top. Yes. That's it. Very simple. This is okay. This one we close up. Look at that piece. This is almost like a very old television, but it plays. What do you think, peeps? Good or not good? It's not bad. I like this magnifying glasses better. But you see, if you go too far, then it gets blur. So this is not a high resolution. This is low resolution beamer. But it works. I see something here. Oh, that's the cloth. And the more you make it dark inside, the better it will get. For now, the box is white inside, so that is also not good. It should be black. Tja. I think mission successful. I just found out by putting the box like 40 degrees, 45 degrees, maybe 40, 30 degrees up. It also kind of gets better. See that? Amazing, huh? I think this one looks way better than... Okay, you can still not see the faces. The faces are not clear. And even if you go too close, then it also gets blur. So, yeah, you must find a way. The best would be a good lens, of course. Magnifying glass is very cheap, what we're using, but this is kind of the biggest. That you can get it. I think it looks pretty good on the iPhone, if I'm looking at the iPhone like that. It looks better on the iPhone than on the wall. It's just a matter of pulling the box a little bit to the back, you know, and then suddenly you have the right position. This is it. Tja. It's a cheap solution for having fun in the dark. With your phone and an old box. Chill. Well, peeps, as you could see, it works. It's unbelievable. Look at this thing, man. Isn't it fantastic? This is the, how shall we call it? This is the square glass, the PUX square glass beamer. I say. Well, I hope you liked this project. It was a pretty long video. Here and there it was maybe a little bit boring, but hey, I have two beamers now under 2 euros. Yeah, 180, 198 to be exactly. No, this glass was a little bit more expensive. This glass was This one was 98 cents, and I think this one was 150. So, yeah, we have a beamer under 4 euros. Two beamers. Yeah. This was it. Let me know if it worked out for you. and how you created yours, and if you used certain lenses. Because for instance, not that I'm gonna do it, but I still have my Sony cam. This was very great cam. This was a Sony mini TV cam. It's very advanced one. But this thing, oh, the lens. This thing also has a lens. Eh? Can you, is it possible to use a lens like this to make a kind of beamer as well? Is it possible? Will I get better results? Or maybe an old lens from the old analog cameras? You know, I still have a kind of big, long, tealy lens. What can I do with a thing like that? Could I also use it as a lens for, you know, this what I'm trying to make? You know, my in the dark player. Let me know in the comments. Of course, if you like this video, leave it a like, even though I disabled likes. You know, likes is, if you give me a like, it's between you and me. Not everybody have to see, right? So, like the video so it will be added to your favorite. Comment to the video if you have better ideas how to make a thing like this. And of course, subscribe to my channel to see even more crazy videos coming up your way.